Praise God. Happy to share with you another verse from the Bible, and this is from Psalm chapter 30, verse 5. For his anger is but for a moment, his favor is for life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Well, how beautiful this verse is. And Psalmist has written it out of his experience in life. Many times he's gone through this cycle, this vicious cycle. His anger is but for a moment. When I was just reading this, you know, God's anger on humanity or on us, many times we undergo this. That is because of, you know, what our activities, our sins, what we have done. So we earn it many a times. But at the same time, it's not only because of that, but sometimes the Lord wants to correct us, to put us on the right path. Well, so that is his anger. And it says in Isaiah chapter 54, verses 7 and 8, for a mere moment I have forsaken you, but with great mercies I will gather you. With a little wrath I hid my face from you for a moment, but with everlasting kindness I will have mercy on you, says the Lord your Redeemer. Mighty children. How beautiful it is. So the anger of the Lord is not going to endure forever. It doesn't mean that, okay, the anger of the Lord is going to stop at some time and his mercy is going to show up. So let me do whatever I like. No, it doesn't mean that way. No, it's not like that. It is that the Lord's anger is not going to stay with us forever. And, you know, his kindness will overtake his anger, and that will last for us. So, in the meantime, do not murmur, do not resist, and do not fear. Just stay cool, calm. Well, wondering what the Lord wants me to do, what the Lord wants to do in me, and how my activities need to change, and what I need to produce in my life. Well, my dear children, so that is what the anger is going to work, and that is only for a moment. So in a moment, which means for a short time or a short spurt of time, well, that moment can be for a few seconds, for a few minutes, for a few months, for a few years as well. And depending on the situation. Well, but we have to endure that because his favor is for life. So that is our confidence. We don't lose heart, actually. So we don't lose heart that what the Lord is going to do. See, the word of God says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. So the night, whenever there is a night, there is a morning, as the next day morning comes in. So the night is not going to be forever. So the anger of the Lord and that situation is not going to stay with us forever. That's going to change. That is what we need to understand. And that's what the psalmist says. If you read through verses in each of these, you know, verses in the psalm, you'll understand that much better. Well, so even in the New Testament, Peter says like this in 1 Peter 5:10, but may the God of all grace who called us to his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you have suffered a while, perfect, establish, strengthen, and settle you. Look at that. So that is what the Lord wants to do in us. He wants to establish. He wants to make us perfect. And that to strengthen and settle. So which means, you know, we need not suffer again. So we need not be in a situation where we would be in need. So ultimately, this also means that the Lord Jesus Christ has done everything for us. And all that we need to do is we have eternal life waiting for us. The sufferings we suffer in this world is but for a moment. It's just like a moment. It's like a twinkling of an eye. It'll just pass away. But the moment after this is going to endure forever. That everlasting life, that eternal life, the life of joy, where there's no sorrow, where there's no difficulty, there's no hurdles, there's only joy, there's no suffering, there's no diseases, everything is gone. There will be no more tears. That's what the Word of God says. So we are being taken in that situation. That's what we need to understand, and thank God, because the Lord, you know, has taken away everything, and every weeping is gone. Because we trusted Him, He's accomplished everything for us, and our trust is in the Lord. And whatever suffering we are going through right now, maybe some kind of a disease, a financial difficulty, maybe whatever might be, but that's only going to be for a moment. For the Lord is going to change everything in our life, and He's going to change and do it for our good. In the process, we're going to learn certain things. We're going to establish this. We're going to get strengthened. And but the end of it, the Lord is going to settle us. And definitely, we will be victorious. Let me pray for you. Heavenly Father, and thank and praise You for this wondrous day. Lord, Your mercy is so great. Lord, You have accomplished everything for us. And let us endure this and learn. And let us, you know, learn to be whatever You want us to be. And at the end of that, You're going to make us victorious. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you. Have a great day.